REZ 2014-16, Bailey, Madison Highway and Williams School Lane, R21 and R1 to M2. Mr. Davenport.
Yes, sir. Just to, again, reiterate some of the finer points on this one. It's got a rich history to this request. They're trying to make an effort to comply with current zoning regulations, and you can see some of the conflicts in your report with trying to do that. With that, I will tell you that the applicant has said they are open to going to an M1 zoning rather than an M2, and you can see how staff and the Planning Commission settled out on their recommendations as far as going with more of a CC direction. With that, I do believe the applicant's agent is here and is willing to speak and address any questions that you might have, as well as staff, on this. We do recognize that there are some challenges with this particular case that might take your questions. With that, we do believe it's ready for your consideration tonight, and I don't have any updates since the work session yesterday.
At this time, do we have any questions for staff before we move into the public portion?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I had a question. I went out there and I saw the area, and I was just wondering how it would possibly impact their business. I mean, based on what I saw out there, I mean, I don't know y'all's interpretation. What does handle hazardous waste mean, I guess, in context of ULDC? Mm-hmm. Would be one question I have.
The applicants, they can probably speak to that, but I don't anticipate their particular uses to be handling any type of hazardous waste, as our code would require some additional information on. We view them more as a currently like a parts distribution or a parts sales service. So when they do handle those parts, they might be dealing with some chemicals that are common to like a repair shop, but we don't know of any chemicals that would trigger any type of special hazardous waste type restrictions.
Any other questions? Okay,
sir.
We'll move into the public participation portion of it.
Chairman.
Excuse me.
Yes, one question. Mr. Davenport, regardless of the change of zoning, they will be able to continue because they're grandfathered in on the current business that they are doing at this point. That's correct?
Yes, sir. That's correct.
Okay.
Any other questions? All right. We'll now move into the public participation portion of it. Is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak in opposition to this request? Anyone in the audience would like to speak in opposition to this request? Hearing none, is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak in favor of this request? Please come forward and state your name and address, please.
My name is Gina Bailey, and I am agent for Chester Bailey of 803 West Cranford Avenue, Valdosta. And firstly, I would like to thank the commission for recognizing October, and I just wanted to point out that I think everyone in the audience is observing the month. All right, we are requesting an M1 rezoning for this property. This business was established in 1971. It's operated since then from that site, and this was before any real zoning existed. The business has always sought to be compliant. So the business has always paid its occupational taxes. It's always been taxed as a business. The property has been taxed as a business location. We've even obtained Department of Health approval for wells that were dug on the property to ensure that they were completely compliant with existing requirements. In 2006, the area was rezoned residential, even though the area is not, in fact, residential. The immediately surrounding area remains the same as it was in 2006 when the rezoning occurred, which is the business that's operated on this particular site. The property across Madison Highway is Timberlands. The property that is across the Williams School Lane is agricultural, and at one time there was actually an auto repair shop being operated from that location. There is a church that operates behind the property, and all of these have coexisted very peaceably throughout these years. Everyone has been respectful of each other's business operations, right? So the area is not and has not become residential in this immediate area. It is, of course, close to the Madison Highway interchange with the interstate, which, of course, is a business area. So, again, it's not inconsistent with the area immediately adjacent or the area that is close to it. So we are seeking the M1 because of the nature of the business, which includes outdoor storage. And this for a heavy machinery parts company is very important because some of these parts are big. So like the buckets for bulldozers and things like that, it's somewhat difficult to store them over, you know, in the building. So sometimes they have to be kept outdoors. There are no hazardous waste operations. This is a parts business. It's buying and selling parts for heavy machinery. So are there any questions?
Do we have any questions for Ms. Bader?
Would CC be suffice for your business to currently operate based on what what's out there and what's going on based on what I saw?
Well, as I said, we are seeking to be fully compliant. We are concerned about a grandfather provision because we don't know what the future may hold for that. CC would not allow the outdoor storage. M1 would.
Mr. Davenport, as moving forward and them being grandfathered in, would the outdoor storage be allowed?
Under their grandfather in use, yes. But if that ever lapsed for whatever reason, and they were a new use with a new tenant, et cetera, then that outdoor storage under CC would not be allowed. So that is a conflict. But under their current use, not a problem. Under a new use, if that grandfathering in ever goes away, that would be an issue with CC.
So Bailey Equipment Company, as it is, would be able to continue to operate as they have been since 1971 under CC zoning?
Yes.
And when he says lapsing, that means not paying the taxes for the year, or?
Typically, when we see non-conforming uses lapse, it's with when the use isn't operated for a period of a year, or they go to expand the use for some reason, like they go to add on to the building or do a significant repair. Those typically trigger additional regulations. But if, you know, if they sold Bailey Equipment Company to someone else and they operated under a different name, as long as they didn't stop for a year and use that property as it has been, that would be allowed to continue. So that ownership change doesn't negate the non-conforming rights.
Right. Is what negates it.
That's right.
If the use changes.
Right. I do want to point out one thing is that significant renovations can trigger the elimination of the grandfather provision. Mm-hmm. And so given the current weather status, if there were a tornado to impact the building would have to be rebuilt. That might cause a conflict with the grandfather provision. So that's another reason why we're very concerned about getting the zoning to reflect the actual operations that have existed there since 1971. We don't want any issues. We're very interested in being compliant.
Mr. Davenport, could that issue be addressed through a condition?
The ordinance, I don't think so, sir. The ordinance currently states a significant repair is greater than 50% of the value of the improvement of the property. So it's a significant repair, but that's something that's currently in the ordinance, sir.
Okay. Any other questions from Ms. Bailey? Okay. Thank you, Ms. Bailey.
All right. Thank you.
Is there anyone else in the audience that would like to speak in favor of this request? Please come forward and state your name and address, please.
My name is Gretchen Quarterman, and I live at 6565 Quarterman Road. My mailing address is 3338 Country Club Road. I'm speaking in favor of this as you're one of your appointees to the Zoning Board of Appeals. Her property would still be non-conforming. And we hear a lot of cases at our board about people who want to In fact, we just had somebody who had to replace a building because it was damaged by a storm. And they had to come to us and get a variance because they were in a non-conforming situation. And in order for them to remove their damaged building and put a fresh one back, they had to get a variance. I really admire a person who wants to get their property for the existing building with all to have it be right. Also, they would be unable to expand their building because they're non-conforming. When you have a non-conforming use, you can't make any addition. So if they wanted to make their building bigger, they'd have to come to the Zoning Board of Appeals and ask us, please, could we do that? You have the opportunity right now to make their business whole. And for a small business owner, I think that's really important that they be have the rights that go with their property for their business. So I would encourage you to please give them zoning that lets them do all the things they do right now. And I don't know whether that's CH or M1, but I'm good with M1 if that's what they need. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else in the audience who would like to speak in favor of this request? Okay, hearing none, we'll turn it back over to the commission.
This is my concern. You know, I think the business is there right now. It's been operating since 1971. I think we need to leave it alone and continue to operate like it's been operating. If we do M1 zoning and they decide to close that business and sell it to somebody else for another purpose, then there may go something goes in there that's inappropriate for that area as a M1 zone. And that's my concern.
I share that concern, and what I don't know is I don't know what the population density is. I see a density map here in front of us, or not a density map, but a zoning map. It looks like R1 and R21 around it, but according to Ms. Bailey, I don't know what is the actual density population. I mean, I think that's another factor to consider as well. I mean, that would make a difference, certainly. I mean, this is a fine line. I think most of us here seem to be saying we want to do whatever we have to do to make sure that this business can function and run like they've always run, but keep that eye to the future. So, Mr. Davenport, do you have any population information on that area?
I think probably the aerial best gives you a sense for that. You can see the aerial where the property is outlined in green. To the west of that, you have a vacant property. Then you have a residence, then a vacant property, and another residence along Madison. If you go to the southern part of that block along Williams, behind the subject property, it does help them because there's a church there. I do believe they have a residence next to that to the west, another residence, I think that's vacant, and then another residence. So you can see that this block, which is Madison Highway to Williams School to Williams Lane, there's some vacant property, but I think it's probably the most of the properties have existing residences on them.
Can we discuss M1 conditional upon the estate of the family owning the property to allow them to continue with all aspects of what they are currently doing, but tie it to the family's ownership of the property?
I think one thing that we need to be concerned about, again, is the density. We've got smaller parcels to the west. Currently, that business has fit well in that community, has worked well as it is, has been probably a good community partner there. However, if the zoning goes to a more intense M1, then you could open it up to metal fabrication or something that could operate a lot of different hours, could have a lot of different noise involved in it, comparatively to what this current business is. Would that be correct, Mr. Davenport?
Yes, sir. And the concern with tying a condition to the ownership is what you set staff up for is we have to set up to monitor the owner. When that ownership changes, you basically say, okay, staff, when that ownership changes, you need to initiate a zoning request on behalf of the board to rezone this property to something different. And so I think that is perfectly within the right of the commission to put a condition on there. It just sets us up for a future rezoning case if that ownership changes.
So if the board pursued CC, if I understand what I'm hearing tonight, if we pursued CC, and, you know, if the building's been there since 1971, mm-hmm. that's 43 years. I don't know how much of the original building still stands, but if they want to do any significant remodeling, or if an act of God or nature were to destroy that building, then what steps would they have to go through? I mean, we don't want to create some burdensome extra step for them to replace their property. What would they have to do to replace that?
If they wanted to replace it to operate with the uses what they have now,
right,
which is kind of heavy equipment repair and
sales. Under CC.
Under CC, then they would have to go back to the Zoning Board of Appeals to say, we'd like to, you know, reestablish our building. It's nonconforming, but because it was destroyed for whatever reason, we'd like to reestablish it and be built so that we can operate it according to that use. And we're just imagining, you know, we don't want it to happen, but something catastrophic happened, then they would be set up for a public hearing to try to reestablish that building, even under CC zone.
Hey, David, I mean, sorry about that. Jason, mm-hmm. hypothetically, if they wouldn't have came to our office or approached the county, what would be taking place right now?
Nothing. They're initiating this request. They have an excellent record with their business licenses or occupational tax registrations. And so unless they approach the county, I'm not aware of any issue or motivation we would have to approach them to say, you need to change this. This is strictly on them to try to settle some things with the operation of that business. They're approaching us. We don't have any outstanding code enforcement or taxation issues with them. This is on their own behalf.
Any other questions? Well, my concern is there doesn't seem to be a prevailing opinion on what's the best way to go, and I'll be honest, at this point, I'd like to table it and see if we can sit down with the owners and come up with something that's going to work for them, which we want to do, but we also are pretty much aware that M1 is not a long-term solution for that piece of property. Okay.
I mean, I would make that motion. I don't know if I'll get a second or not, but.
You have that privilege. You can put that in the form of a motion.
Before we do that, Commissioner Powell, if I'm looking at the zoning, allowable zonings, Mr. Davenport, mm-hmm. am I correct that regarding this property, CC versus M1, the difference would be, well, those essentially are the same. What are the primary differences between those two zonings?
If you look at, Commissioner, and this is, you know, staff really drilled down into this.
Right.
But if you look at that table where it's a current use cut, current uses and allowable zonings. The biggest differences for their uses would be that heavy equipment repair, because salvage is no longer something they're really pursuing actively, and so that's why they've backed down to at least an M1 zoning. Okay. Heavy equipment repair in CC or CH, there are some additional standards for that use, whereas M1 and M2 don't have the additional standards. For CC, CG and CH under heavy equipment sales, there are additional standards, whereas M1 and M2 are allowed without the additional standards. For outdoor storage, CH, M1 and M2 will allow it. CC will not allow outdoor storage, just as a matter of right. And then an office is allowed in any of them. So we really tried to detail their uses. The biggest conflict we found in CC was that outdoor storage with a new use would be an issue. Otherwise, CC and CH, the commercial zonings, appear to have some additional restrictions on them that maybe an M1 would not have. So I tried to make that table for you, but those are the biggest conflicts that we've seen to find, is the commercial zoning seem to have additional restrictions that manufacturing M1 does not, and then CC zoning would pose a problem for a new use with outdoor storage.
If they wanted to put this business anywhere else in the county, they would have to pursue an M1 or M2 zoning, right?
Yes, sir.
I don't think it's such a bad idea to table it, Commissioner Powell, because
I almost think we should pursue some sort of M1 with conditions.
Yes.
But I don't know what those conditions need to be, but I think if there would be an earthquake that swallowed that building, on top of trying to figure out how to feed their family, they're going to be having to sign up for a zoning board of appeal to build that building, and who wants that? I think that everything's fine the way it is. I don't know. That's just my uneducated opinion.
Mr. Chairman, okay. I move that we table.
Okay. We have a motion to table. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second. Any discussion? Hearing none, we'll call the vote. All in favor of the motion, signify by aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, like sign. Motion is unanimous.